Yeah, Rapul and Luke, it's just two guys born from Rustenburg, came to Joburg in about 1995, started working here. He did his job at whichever company he was working for, and I worked for a whole different company, you know. And along the way, we formed this company, Max Output, which is the company that we're currently running today.
There was another business before. It morphed into this, what it is now, but it was mainly supply of components and parts to the motor industry, you know. But the business was growing at a very slow pace, and we decided to move into manufacturing. That's when the manufacturing aspect of it came in. But the manufacturing had always been there in the background. Not so soon. We didn't anticipate that we would start it so soon. But it was going to be a different manufacturing altogether. It was not going to be steel and fabrication. It was something else, completely different. Look, it's an industry that hasn't really transformed much. And for us, for young guys like us, coming from where we come from, it's with our background, it's very difficult in that they're already players that know each other, and they've been doing their business for a very long time. And you need a lot of experience, years of experience, to be in the industry, you know.
Yes, it also involved a bit of luck, you know, just having a bit of luck, and also identifying opportunities and then being able to act on those opportunities. Because, you know, if you just happen to be at the right place at the right time, and then there's an opportunity there, then you just grab that opportunity, you know.
Yeah, so we realized that on our own, with the lack of experience in manufacturing, we were not really going to cut it. We're not going to get very far. We would have, yes, tried it, but we're not going to make the kind of margins that we needed to make. We're not going to take the business where it needed to be. So we had to partner with somebody that was already in the industry, that had been in the industry for years, somebody with experience. Both businesses were very successful in that collaboration. Had we not done that, we would have grown, both companies would have grown, but not to the exponential levels that we currently saw, well, are at the moment, you know.
Partnering also with the biggest competitor, you know, it also opened up opportunities to be able to learn. Because, I mean, coming from where we came from, we didn't know quite a lot about the industry. Like, we didn't know anything, in fact, you know. But being exposed to the stuff that you're exposed to from the competitor side, it gave us an insight of what the industry is really about and what is it that you should look out for and what are the potential challenges that you might face as things goes along. If we had to make the money and then start spending that money, chances are we wouldn't have been able to acquire all these assets, you know. So instead of getting money and then using it, spending it as things goes along, we took the money. And then we put it aside because we had a vision. We knew what we wanted to do, you know. It took quite a long time because now also you can sit there with the money, but if there's no work coming in, it doesn't really mean anything, you know. Accumulated a bit of interest, invested it. Well, he was very good with the investment at the time because he used to be a banker, you know.
I still am.
So it just made things really simple for us, you know, because he knew the right place where to invest the money and stuff like that. So through that, we're able to accumulate more and more money, you know. But as an advice to any other entrepreneur will be, instead of just spending the money, rather keep it until you're really certain about what is it that you want to do with your business, you know.
I think the other important thing is that, because you hear people asking you about funding and you know, how did you fund the business? Where can I go to get funding, right? If you do have a side hustle, if I can call it that way, like you were saying, put those funds aside. But the thing that set us apart is that we went for a business that didn't require a lot of capital to start. For us to start the business of supplying the automotive industry, it didn't really require, it required capital, yes, like any other business, but it didn't require as much, you know, for us to get started. And once we got started and we put those funds aside, then that's when we started really seeing the difference. So entrepreneurs can look at that. People want to start big. You cannot always start big. Start small, and then that's when it means a lot, and that's where you will actually see the rewards. So we have done quite a bit of work for Ford with regards to the T19, Ford Ranger, Ford Everest, and now there's a Raptor as well. So we worked quite a lot of projects with them that we've been entrusted with. And we're very fortunate that they've trusted us with this big task, you know. And yeah, and then the main thing is that our main focus has been the quality of work that we do and the turnaround time. And they have seen that. We've proven that along the years. It took a bit of time, but they have seen that we produce good quality work, and still we're able to turn it around at the time frames that they want us to do it, because they have their deadlines, you know. So we have to adhere to those and still produce the good quality work. So those are not it's not an easy task doing both, you know, because you can knock a project out of the park very quickly, but the quality, you know what I mean, might not be up to the standard that a company like that requires, and the quality requirements are very, very high. So we have to adhere to that. The standards are quite high. We have to adhere to that. I think looking into the future, we want to take on, look, it's a lot more men here, but we're hoping to even the ratio a bit by taking on a few more female fabricators, if I can put it that way, in the long run, you know. But it's for that to happen, we have to go looking. It's not, if you have people looking for a job here, if five people come here, four out of that five are male. So that means we only have one female to choose from, you know, and we benchmark. Obviously, the quality will tell us if we're taking a person or not. But more often than not, it's the majority is males that come here. So we have to go looking for us to even those numbers, to even that ratio, you know. So, but we're looking into doing that, and we're looking at starting programs that can actually do that for us, working with, in conjunction with our HR manager. So that's one thing for the next financial year that we're looking, really focusing on.
For more stories like these, go to www.social-tv.co.za. Subscribe to us on YouTube and follow us on our social mediums.